In this presentation, we are going to talk about morphological classification of plants. On the basis of morphology, plants can be classified as cryptogams or phanerogams. Cryptogams are non-flowering plants, that is, they reproduce through spores that are hidden in the bodies. They have very simple internal structure. Cryptogams can further be subdivided into diverse forms such as bacteria, algae, fungi, bryophyta, lichens, and pteridophyta. Let us see one by one. Bacteria are single-celled plants. They are also called as schizophyta. They reproduce by cell division and they are non-vascular plants. Bacteria can further be divided into autotrophic bacteria and heterotrophic bacteria. As the name suggests, autotrophic bacteria are those that produce their own food with the help of photosynthesis, while heterotrophic bacteria, they have to depend on the dead organic matter for the purpose of their food. So they don't produce their own food. Next is algae. Algae are water living microplants. Obviously, some also live in soil. Some algae are single celled while some are multi celled, and they get their energy through photochemical mechanism, that is from the light. They are also non-vascular plants. Fungi, all of you know, because all of you have seen mushrooms. Fungi are heterotrophs, so they are dependent on others. Now, some fungi can be parasites, they directly depend on others, while some are saprophytes, that is, they derive their food from the dead organic matter, for example mushrooms. These are also non-vascular plants. Next is bryophyta. Bryophyta are non-vascular plants. The two examples, mosses and liverworts. You can see liverworts on the top and mosses at the bottom, right side. Then we have lichens. Now, lichens are mixed or composite plants. They carry algae and fungi together as internal components of a single plant. They are partly chemotroph, that is, they produce their food through chemosynthesis, for example algae, and partly they are heterotroph, that is fungi, that derive food from chemotroph algae. Then there is pteridophyta. Pteridophyta are vascular plants. They reproduce through spores. Fern and horsetails are the examples. Ferns, I think you can easily identify on the top, while the picture at the bottom is horsetails. The next classification are phanerogams. The plants that we saw just now and the cryptogams, they were non-flowering plants. Now, phanerogams are flowering plants. They reproduce offsprings through seeds. They are also called as spermatophyta, that is, carry, because they carry sperms, and these are vascular plants. Phanerogams are further divided into gymnosperms and angiosperms. As the chart clearly says, gymnosperms are those that carry naked seeds, that is, seeds that do not contain any outer shell or outer cover, while angiosperms carry the seeds that are inside a shell or inside a covering, so they are called as angiosperms. So as I said, gymnosperm carry their seeds in open form. They are not closed under any cover of shell. This includes various genera of temperate coniferous forest, for example pine and spruce. Angiosperms, they carry seeds closed in protective cover or in body tissues. They are the most dominant group of vascular plants and the most evolved group of flowering plants. Angiosperms can further be subdivided into dicotyledon and monocotyledons. Now, dicotyledons are those who bear two leaves at the time of seed germination, as you can see in the photograph below. Now, these includes leguminous plants, fruit-bearing plants. So there can be number of examples. It can be peas, grams, mango, etc. While some plants are monocotyledons, that is, they bear single leaves at the time of seed germination. You can clearly see the difference in both the pictures, where one picture has two leaves at the time of germination, while one has the other one, that is angiosperms, only have a single one. Now, the examples of angiosperm include number of cereal crops. It includes wheat, maize, millets, etc. So, students, you are ready for an assignment. So, on the basis of this, you can write this assignment. Explain the morphological classification of plants with suitable example for 10 marks. Now, as a part of your answer structure, give a very brief introduction on plant classification, and then move on to morphological classification to talk about cryptogams and phanerogams. Don't forget to include chart with names and examples, because in this answer you are going to talk about classification. Do refer Savindra Singh's biogeography book, because that will help you to write your answer with some more examples and more description of it. I hope you have enjoyed this small video presentation. Thanks a lot.